Ladies and gentlemen, the following feature contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied to the ring by Colonel Robert Parker from Bucksnort, Tennessee, weighing 256 pounds, Bunkhouse Buck!
And this will be our main event here on WCW Pro Wrestling with the Pro Team. The American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, a living legend, Larry Zbysko, and yours truly, Gordon Sullivan. And we're getting set now to go back into the ring to hear the introduction of a young man from Nuremberg, Germany.
Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Nuremberg, Germany. Germany's youngest professional wrestler, Das Wunderkind, Alex
Bunkhouse Buck. I know he's not a fashion plate, but this guy knows how to wrestle when you least expect it.
Okay.
We'll see if Alex Wright expects it.
Well, legend, let me tell you something. Alex Wright is on a real roll. We had talked about him stepping up in competition. I don't know the role of underdog, if you will. I think the bottom line here is Alex Wright, if he continue with his game plan and flying and moving around with quick speed, he'll be on top of that game because, brother, you know, no one knows what a loss can do to you on WCW Pro.
And we'll get set to go with this match after this timeout. Hitting that for the bell. There it is, and our main event is underway here on WCW Pro on a Saturday morning. Alex Wright against Bunkhouse Buck. Single leg sweep that time, and an inside step over toehold by Bunkhouse Buck. And
well, there's so much for your speed theory. He's not running nowhere in this predicament.
Yeah, well, what is he doing there holding the rope?
Well, he's got a little illegal advantage there, but, you know, the interesting thing about this is the very fact that you were talking about the speed and all of Alex Wright. And that's Bunkhouse Buck's theory, or apparently Colonel Parker's theory. Take away that speed, take away that point of balance.
That's good, Gun, but bottom line is, Bunkhouse Buck don't have the mentality to think of that itself. I'm talking about Colonel Parker had to lay this game plan down, and this is, it's got to be a good game plan if he can make it happen, Larry.
It don't matter who writes out the game plan, it only matters who wins the game. And right now, I mean, the approach Bunkhouse Buck is taking, he's taking out the wheel of Alex Wright, and henceforth, he takes away the speed.
Yeah, well,
good plan.
Yeah, well, he's cheating right now, grabbing the rope and putting
it's not cheating.
What is it called?
Taking advantage of the situation. Alex Wright has bad ring positioning. Bunkhouse Buck is taking advantage of it.
Oh, come on.
And again.
Where are you going? Back for the food?
You ate all the chips.
Spring and after those quadricep femoris muscles, after the knee itself, Bunkhouse Buck really concentrating on that left leg, keeping the pressure mounting at all times, and Colonel Parker shouting encouragement to him. So,
you know, Gunn, you know, Parker only got one man left in that situation. Now, we're talking about Ming, the big Ming, the bad dude is left in that U.S. tournament that's going on Saturday night. And I think he really needs a victory right here with Bunkhouse Buck.
Yeah, he does indeed. It will be Ming tonight in the U.S. Heavyweight Championship Tournament against Marcus Alexander Bagwell. And I'll guarantee you one thing. Ming has had some sensational victories with that spinning savant to the head. I don't think you're going to get that done against Marcus Bagwell. He's had enough time to study this man and to be alert for it.
We'll talk about someone that better keep moving. Bagwell better keep moving. Maybe out to Los Angeles or something.
Yeah, I think Bagwell got a good shot at tonight. It's going to be a great main event. WCW Saturday night. Going to be tough right here. Boy, look at him biting him there. Come on, ref, get in there.
Talk about the psychological fear being instilled in this young man by Bunkhouse Buck right there. I mean, this guy's got to be confused. You're taking away his mobility. He's got to be thinking. But when you're, you know, 19, 20 years old, those butterflies in your stomach get real big when you get confused.
Well, it's Bunkhouse Buck continuing to press that advantage and being told by the referee to watch his tactics. Nick Patrick is the official in the ring, and Bunkhouse Buck still punishing that left leg.
You know, Gunn, every great athlete, every great champion has to have that ability to recuperate when you're hurt or when you got a part of your body that's hurt, whether it be football, baseball, boxing, or the great sport of wrestling. You got to come back and you got to make that. And I think Alex Wright's not true in this situation, but he's in a situation we haven't seen him in, and that goes back to when we talked about stepping up to the post against top of competition. They can't get no top of than one of Colonel Parker's men right here.
That is a natural born fact of Wright. I don't don't know whether he's going to be able to measure up to this test or not. We might be seeing for the first time here on WCW that Alex Wright is defeated. He is undefeated at this point.
So I tell you, the game plan is excellent right here. Definitely taking away the speed and the mobility of Alex Wright, which will leave him virtually helpless if he cannot recover. And the longer Bunkhouse maintains control, the less chance this guy's going to ever recover.
You know, Gordon, talking about Slamboree 2 right here, you know, with Hogan and Savage and the Renegade in the corner, you know, Flair and Vader, look at that matchup tonight. I hear you, Tony, and I know we're really looking forward to WCW tonight. Is it Arn Anderson and Ric Flair together with tag team? Two of the original four horsemen. Wow, what a barn burner tonight.
And it'll be Tony Schiavone and Bobby the Brain bringing you all the action tonight on WCW Saturday night. And we certainly urge you to check it out.
Look at Bunkhouse Buck here. Reverse drop, toe hold, just dropping down on that right there. All the weight on the ankle, up to the knee of Alex Wright. And this kid looks confused, trying to make it to the rope because he doesn't know how to escape this. What a game plan Colonel Parker has laid out.
Well, I'm glad you agree that Colonel Parker laid it out, not Bunkhouse Buck, because I said
well,
he don't have that
difference.
There's a lot of, oh, would you stop it?
Once again, the referee warning Bunkhouse Buck about using the top ring rope for extra leverage, and he plants a boot into the back of the knee of Alex Wright. And Alex Wright now limping noticeably. And those muscles have been really badly abused. Nice leg sweep by Alex Wright. As Bunkhouse Buck charged in, Alex Wright caught that leg and swept it out from under. Another good leg sweep by Alex Wright, hooking that near leg. And now Alex Wright beginning to return the favors issued to him in the past by the young man from Bucksnort, Tennessee. Alex Wright lashing out with that boot again to the quadriceps femoris muscles of the Bunkhouse Buck. Alex Wright now twisting in the toe hold.
Yeah.
And Bunkhouse Buck makes it to the ropes.
Yeah, he went for a little more leverage here. Yeah. Rope leverage, Larry.
For the first time, Alex Wright had a chance to move, and he did. He moved. Bunkhouse Buck is down. We'll see what Alex Wright can do if he can maintain the offense. Hitting a couple moves is nice, but the offense is what will give you the key.
Well, it goes back to recuperating, and that's what he's trying to do right here. WCW Pro, I'm telling you right here, he can't make no mistakes against Bunkhouse Buck, or he'd be right back down on that mat.
Bunkhouse Buck brought to the canvas once again by Alex Wright. He tried to hold on to the ring ropes. Alex Wright hooked that up, goes into a single leg Boston Crab. And Bunkhouse Buck trying to get out to those ropes to force the break.
Look at how Bunk is trying to keep that leg extended. If you notice Alex Wright's position here, he's got to be up higher. He's got to be over the small of the back. He's too low, and it's not enough pressure to hurt the Bunkhouse.
Alley hooks that other leg now and goes into a full Boston Crab. But you're right there. He was able to practically bridge up on
it. Well, he's up too high, and he can't get the pressure.
Well, he just busted that knee on that apron right there. Boy, he needs to stay on the offense right here. Can't let up. Kick him anywhere. Kick him in the hind end. I don't care.
But yeah, Alex Wright should definitely have more endurance. He's got hardly any body fat. If he can keep moving. Ooh. Oh, there's the tricks of the trade that will come into effect here.
Well, this is a situation he don't want to be in. We talk about it so much when you're out there with the manager, and I'm telling you, we will either see some clever in here or some bad deeds going on if he don't get back in that ring, Gordon. So,
yeah, he will, and Bunkhouse Buck will back into the ring, and Colonel Parker now approaching. Oh, man, Colonel Parker with cheap shots.
Hey, ref, turn around, ref. Hey, ref, don't bother the ref.
What do you mean?
To Bunkhouse.
Yeah, would you say he's out of position?
Well, Bunkhouse Buck is in the ring.
Alex Wright coming up very slowly now, and it's Bunkhouse Buck hooking the head, bringing him up, bending him back over the top rope. Big, massive forearm across the chest of Alex Wright. He's down on the ring apron. Well, as I said before, we're coming closer and closer to it. We may be seeing Alex Wright's first defeat in World Championship Wrestling.
You know, I think Bunkhouse Buck, Colonel Parker's strategy there came very effective at the beginning of the match. They slowed Alex Wright down from the onset.
Hey, Rip.
And this guy just quiet here. And this guy just hasn't been able to recoup yet. He tried, but Bunkhouse Buck, when you get that experience, you know, all those little tricks of the trade, And Alex Wright's in big trouble.
Bunkhouse Buck bringing him back through the ropes. Whoa. And throws him through on the other side.
But yeah, hey, ref, turn around. See this situation right here? That's what I... That's outside interference, ladies and gentlemen. Come on, ref.
Well, it would be if the ref saw it.
Well, is he blind?
Probably he's a ref.
Alex Wright laboriously getting back to his feet now.
Ooh, laboriously. That is a big word. I love that word, laboriously.
Now, it's...
Does that mean he's lumbering, Doug?
No, it's just, it's really laboring. He's really laboring trying to get up. Hey, Alex Wright explodes with a couple of right hands, and Bunkhouse Buck retaliates. And we've got a pair of sixes started here. Both of them swapping punches back and forth into each other's jaws. And it is Bunkhouse Buck who has been staggered. Bunkhouse Buck staggers back across the ring. Alex Wright over the top with a good drop kick. And it is Alex Wright moving in on Bunkhouse Buck. He plants a boot through the midsection. Catches him with a bolo-like forearm. Another bolo-like forearm by Alex Wright. And this young man from Nuremberg, Germany, has got it all together as he gets a lateral press and hooks the parlay. Bunkhouse Buck staggers back to his feet. Alex Wright continues to pursue him. And he's catching him with hard right hands.
Well, yeah. Colonel Parker is not looking happy about this. Whoa.
Back clip now by Alex Wright, and it is Colonel.
Oh man,
Bunkhouse Buck caught him coming in.
That stopped your momentum right there, boy, and he had plenty of it. Got to reach back now, Alex Wright. Oh, good.
Flying cross body. Bucky hooks the fire into Alex Wright. He's racked up a tremendous victory.
Sure, it was right. What are you watching? Which match are you looking at?
I'm looking at the man's shoulder. The referee is blind.
Right, Alex Wright got silly. Alex Wright just took a giant step up that ladder because we talked about him with competition. How would he fare with it? And right there, really against two men, he took it.
He did indeed, and he had great intestinal fortitude. We're taking another look at him right here, and Alex Wright is looking good.
Well, we see Alex Wright making his move here, kind of knocked the wind out of Bunkhouse Buck, but right here didn't expect this diving off the top, but look where the referee is, and look at that shoulder.
Nice win.
Oh, come on.
Don't forget, WCW Saturday Night Tonight. On behalf of the Pro Team, this is Gordon Solis saying join us again next week, same time.